Well, we can talk now to the Labour MP, Stephen Kinnock, who was there to hear the Prime Minister's statement a little bit earlier on, and also to hear the response of your leader, Jeremy Corbyn, which has been criticised by some Labour MPs who are angry that he didn't explicitly condemn Russia and explicitly say that the Russian state was behind this attack. What's your view on that?
Yes, I think there were two big things missing from Jeremy's statement. One was the lack of an explicit condemnation of what the Russians have done, and the other, to say, in fact, we stand shoulder to shoulder with the Prime Minister. I disagree with the Prime Minister on a lot of things, but I think on this, her response has been robust. In many ways, I'd like her to go further. I think we should be approaching FIFA to explore the possibility of postponing the World Cup until 2019 and relocating it to another host country or countries. But I still think, you know, she put forward some robust measures and showed that we're resolute in the face of this completely unacceptable Russian behaviour. And I think it would have been better if Jeremy had come in behind her on that.
Our political editor, Laura Koonsberg, has been tweeting that some Labour front benchers are so angry they could resign over this. Are you hearing any of that kind of anger?
Well, I've been in the chamber, actually, because we have another debate now on Brexit, so I haven't had a chance, really, to talk to that many colleagues. Of course, it will be up to colleagues to examine their own position on this. I do feel that a lot of us on the backbenches were uncomfortable and are uncomfortable with the position. I think we need to come out now really strongly as a party in the tradition of Clement Attlee and so many other great leaders that we've had who've stood four square behind the security of this country. We need to take a patriotic position on this. Of course, we must engage with Russia. We must have robust dialogue. As the director of the British Council in St. Petersburg, 05 to 08, we did a tremendous amount to work with that new generation of Russians coming through, and we must continue to do that. But we must also take absolutely unequivocal measures about the fact that this is an attack on the United Kingdom with a military-grade nerve agent, and that is about as serious as it gets.
The suggestion that Labour MPs may sign, or some MPs may sign, a motion that would explicitly say that Russia was behind this attack. Would you sign a motion like that?
I haven't seen the motion, but I am convinced that this sort of attack, with the geopolitical impact that it would have, couldn't have taken place without clearance at the highest levels in the Kremlin. The Russian state wouldn't be taking these kind of risks, particularly in the year of the World Cup, without a sign-off from the most senior level. So I'm absolutely prepared to say that I do believe that the deep state, as we might call it in Russia, is involved in this. We need to take the strongest possible action. My worry with the World Cup in the summer is it's almost a global vindication of the Putin regime. And if it goes ahead, a celebration of the beautiful game, a great opportunity for Vladimir Putin to showcase his own regime and his country at a time when they are flouting the rule of law and carrying out assassinations or attempted assassinations on the territory of a NATO member state. And let's not forget, this is a direct follow-up on what happened with Alexander Litvinenko, an even more outrageous attack, some might say, because it used a very rare radioactive substance. So there's a pattern of behaviour here. Do we really think that holding the World Cup in Russia is the right way to express the outrage of the international community?
But a lot of people say, actually, sports boycotts of the type that you are suggesting don't really work.
Well, I think if you look at what happened with South Africa, the apartheid regime, I would argue that the boycotting of South African sport, particularly the rugby, was probably the most effective sanction of all, leading to the end of the apartheid regime and the release of Nelson Mandela from prison. So I would actually argue that sport plays an incredibly important role. There are millions of Russians who are looking forward to having the World Cup in the country. The Russian state has spent billions of rubles on preparing the country. I think it's actually one of the very few instruments we have at our disposal to do Putin some real damage.
But if England didn't go to the World Cup, I mean, it's not going to have Vladimir Putin quaking in his boots, is it?
I'm not actually suggesting we have a unilateral boycott. I'm saying, and what I actually said in the House to the Prime Minister, she should make an approach, build a coalition of other football associations and approach FIFA to have the World Cup itself postponed until 2019 and relocated to a different host country or countries next year. I don't think a unilateral boycott by the English team would be the right way to go. I do think that we should be seriously looking at postponing the World Cup until 2019 and holding it in a far more appropriate country or countries.
One other suggestion that has been made is shutting down Russia Today, RT, the Russian TV channel that broadcasts here in the UK. Would you go along with that as well?
I'm not so sure about that, because my worry with that is the Russians would immediately shut down the BBC, both World Service and BBC more broadly, and possibly attacks on other Western media. And I think one of the things that's really important is that we keep a channel open to the Russian people, keep communicating to the Russian people. I will always remember the wonderful Russians, many of them quite young, who worked for me in St. Petersburg when I was there as the director. And they're the new generation, this new Russian middle class coming through, who detest the isolationism and the despotic nature of the Putin regime. They want Russia to be open to the rest of the world. They want to see a new way of doing business, a new democracy coming through. We've got to stay open and keep engaged with those people. I think people-to-people diplomacy is so important at this time. And of course, outlets such as the BBC play a vital role in that.
Okay, Stephen Kinnock, thank you very much indeed for being with us.